Oh, Anne, this makes up for everything, doesn't it? Let's resolve to keep this day sacred to perfect beauty all our lives for the gift it has given us. It's the birthday of our happiness, said Anne softly. I've always loved this old garden of Hester Gray's, and now it will be dearer than ever. But I'll have to ask you to wait a long time, Anne, said Gilbert sadly. It will be 3 years before I'll finish my medical course, and even then there will be no diamond sunbursts and marble halls. Anne laughed. I don't want sunbursts and marble halls. I just want you. You see, I'm quite as shameless as Phil about it. Sunbursts and marble halls may be all very well, but there is more scope for imagination without them. And as for the waiting, that doesn't matter. We'll just be happy waiting and working for each other, and dreaming. Oh, dreams will be very sweet now. Gilbert drew her close to him and kissed her. Then they walked home together in the dusk, crowned king and queen in the bridal realm of love, along winding paths fringed with the sweetest flowers that ever bloomed, and over haunted meadows where winds of hope and memory blew. End of chapter 41. End of Anne of the Island by Lucy Maud Montgomery.
Anne's House of Dreams by Lucy Maud Montgomery. Chapter 1. In the Garret of Green Gables. "Thanks be, I'm done with geometry, learning or teaching it," said Anne Shirley a trifle vindictively, as she thumped a somewhat battered volume of Euclid into a big chest of books, banged the lid in triumph, and sat down upon it, looking at Diana Wright across the Green Gables garret, with gray eyes that were like a morning sky. The garret was a shadowy, suggestive, delightful place, as all garrets should be. Through the open window by which Anne sat blew the sweet, scented, sun-warm air of the August afternoon. Outside, poplar boughs rustled and tossed in the wind. Beyond them were the woods, where Lover's Lane wound its enchanted path, and the old apple orchard, which still bore its rosy harvest munificently. And over all was a great mountain range of snowy clouds in the blue southern sky. Through the other window was glimpsed a distant, white-capped blue sea, the beautiful St. Lawrence Gulf, on which floats like a jewel Abegwite, whose softer, sweeter Indian name has long been forsaken for the more prosaic one of Prince Edward Island.